Today's topic is androecium. Androecium is the essential whole of the plant. It is male reproductive part of plant, male reproductive part of flower. It is made up of anther and filament, a lobed anther and a long filament. This is filament. Anther, usually bilobed, and filament. Filament is long tube-like structure. Filament. This male reproductive organ comprises androecium of the flower. Anther is usually bilobed, four chamber, which is known as pollen sac. In pollen sac, pollen grains produce. This is anther, usually bilobed. Each lobe has two chamber, and in these chamber, pollen grains are produced. A sterile stamen is known as staminode. This is a sterile stamen. Most of the anther are bilobed, which is known as diathecus. Di means two. Diathecus, two lobe, and it is attached through a connector. Sometimes this anther is one lobed, which is monothecus. Mono means one. Monothecus. On the basis of attachment of anther and filament, we can also divide it into many types. Attachment between anther and filament. First one is basifixed. That means anther is attached to the filament on the base. This is anther part of stamen, and filament is attached to its base. It is known as basifix. Filament is attached from the base. Second type is dorsifix. Dorsifixed. In this type, anther is attached to the filament. Filament is attached to the anther at dorsal position. This type of fixation is known as dorsifix. Third is adirect type. In this type of stamen, anther is attached to the entire length of the anther. And the last is versatile type. When stamen is large, anther of stamen is large, it is attached in this way. This is known as versatile type of attachment. Anther's lobes are large. these attachment is in that type of plant which are found in windy places where pollination is done through the wind, in which pollination is done by the wind. Nation in plant is done with the help of wind. So in dorsiflex, filament is attached dorsally to the anther. In adrate type, filament is attached towards entire length of the anther, and in versatile type, in which it is attached in this manner. Next point. The stamen of inflower may either remain free, that is polyandrous. Polyandrous. In this type of flower, stamen remain free. They are attached to the central axis. Single stamen. Stamen remain free. And these are anthers, these are filament. That means it is freely attached to the central axis. These type of stamen is known as polyandrous. Or in another case, they are united, they are fused. United or fused stamen. Depending upon the type of fusion, how they are fused, how they are united, it can be divided into three types. First is known as adelphous type of fusion. Adelphous. In this type, stamen may be unified, united, fused. Stamen are into one bunch. In adelphous type, filament remains fused and anthers free. Anthers remain free. United filament, anthers free is the characteristic of adelphous type. Depending upon the how much bunch they form, it may be divided into monoadelphous. In monoadelphous, as the name indicate, filament are in one bunch. That is filament. They are in one bunch. They are fused filament and anthers are free. Anthers are free. These are anthers which are free. This is monoadelphous type of attachment. Example is China rose. If filaments are in two bunch, it is diadelphous. Diadelphous. Filaments are in two bunch. These are one bunch, and this is another bunch. This is one bunch, and this is another bunch. In family Papilionaceae, this type of stamen are formed. Family Papilionaceae. Nine stamens are close together. Filament of nine stamens are fused, and one lie sidewise. Nine stamens, filament of nine stamens is together, and one is another side. This is the characteristic of family Papilionaceae, diadelphous type. Third one is polyadelphous. in Polyedelphus. Polyedelphus. In Polyedelphus type, it is in many bunch. They are fused in many bunch. Filaments are fused in many bunch, but anthers remain free. Filaments are 1, 2, 3. These are bunches of filament. And anthers are remain free. Anthers lie upon filament freely. These are the example of, in this type, we keep cypress plant. Cypress plant. Another type of stamen is, in which anthers fuse filament free. Anthers remain fused. Anther remains fused. Fused, but filament free. Filament remains free. These are known as synanthers. Synanthers. That's because anthers are fused. It is also known as syngenesis. Syngenesis. This example of this is family Asteraceae. Example of this is family Asteraceae. This is the characteristic of family Asteraceae. In it, anther fused, usually anthers are bilobed, so anther of one stamen fused with another stamen. Anther, these are the fused anther. Anthers are fused together and the filament remains free. These are the example of synanther or syngenesis. The third type is anther and filament are fused. Whole body is fused. That means anther as well as filament remains fused. These are the example of this is family Cucurbitae. In this whole anther and filament remains fused, get together, united. On the basis of length of the filament, androecium can be divided into two bites. Length of the filament. Androecium may be divided into two types. First is didynamous. Didynamous. In this four stamen, two outer stamen and two inner stamen. Two outer stamen are long and two inner stamen are short in this type. Two outer stamen are long whereas two inner stamen are short. This is known as didynamous type of androecium. Example is Salvia Osimum. Another is Tetradidynamous. Tetra Didymus. Or six, it contains six stamen. Two outer are short, whereas four inner are tall. In this, two outer are short, four inner are tall. Two outer are short, whereas four inner stamen are tall. This is known as tetradynamous. Example of this is Brachyaceae, family Brachyaceae. Some words are frequently used to describe addition of stamen to other fold, other parts of plant. First is epipetalous. Epipetalous is the when stamen are attached to the petal. When stamen are attached to the petal, it is known as epipetalous. Example is brinjal. Next is epiphyllous. When attachment to the perianth in the flower, when stamen is attached to the perianth, it is known as epiphyllous condition. When attached to the perianth, it is known as epiphyllous condition. Epiphyllous type of addition of stamen. What is perianth? When sepal and petal are not distinguished. Sepal and petals are not distinguished. They remain fused. Not distinguished means they remain fused. They remain fused and look similar, not distinguishable. This is known as perianth. So when a stamen is attached to the perianth, this condition is known as epiphyllous. This is all about the term androecium means male reproductive part of plant. This is androecium.